So I had the chance to play through Balan Wonderworld, which is the newest original game by Yuji Naka, the creator of Sonic and Knights. I looked online and a lot of people really don't like this game. There's a lot of people who have a lot of things to say about it, so I wanted to kind of talk about it myself and put into perspective some of my own thoughts. First of all, I just gotta say, and most people agree, the cutscenes in this game are absolutely incredible and they set a high standard early out. The game, when you start it up on the demo, starts with a couple opening cutscenes to establish the plot, establish the tone, establish why we are in this strange dreamlike world we are once the cutscenes end, and they are absolutely incredible to look at. The overall tone and use of bright colors in the bloom definitely reminds me of Knights, which is clearly what Yuji Naka was going for in the vision for this aesthetically. And, you know, I'm not complaining. Right after these cutscenes, though, is where I think the opinions from a lot of people start to break down. They start to dissipate. This is when people start to have a lot of negative things to say about this game. You go on YouTube right now, and you look up this game and people's impressions of the demos, you get a bunch of video titles that are like, Balan Wonderworld Demo, we're not impressed. I hate the Balan Wonderworld Demo. Balan probably sucks penises in real life. Which is an opinion. Horrible to say, and maybe true. It's not for me to say, not that there's anything wrong with that. I started watching some of these videos because I was like, oh shit, oh this sucks, because I was really looking forward to the game. So when I started looking into the impressions of it and I saw that people weren't enjoying it, I got a little worried because I still really wanted to like the game. And then I played the game and I didn't arrive to the same conclusion that these other people are. I actually like Balan Wonderworld a lot. I have to wait for the full game to come out before I can conclude that for certain, but at least as of right now, I still intend on buying it day of. The common threads that I saw throughout all of the impression videos that I saw culminated around three main things: the controls, the lack of controls, and then the graphics. There's also a part where people were making a mockery of a model in a cutscene in game where one of the bosses was T-posing, and I don't really care. Haha, it's super funny to dunk and meme on the games. I don't care. It doesn't affect anything. Remember fun? Remember when games were just supposed to be fun things and that was it?
Get the fuck over yourself.
I really do love that, like, the collective opinion about this game just rallies around it not being like Knights and not being like Sonic and not being like Super Mario Odyssey. You really shouldn't be judging a game based on what it isn't, and should instead just measure the merits of something based on what it is. I understand just being disappointed or having your hopes let down. That's totally reasonable. You know, we're all people. We've all felt that before. That's totally fine. You know, you can just say you don't like Balan Wonderland because it turned out to not be what you want. Because what it is still a fine game. You just don't like that you can't run fast. You don't like that all the buttons on the face buttons of the controller do the same thing. And you don't like that when you use the flower power-up and you make yourself tall and then you let go, you don't hop forward like you do in Mario Odyssey. Or how when you jump, you slow down a little bit, but in Mario Odyssey, you don't do that. Hey, why can you have a bunch of costumes, but none of them are like in Mario Odyssey? Levels are semi-linear. You try to get from beginning to end. There is a main beginning to end route that you can take, but every step along the way are little completion things and collect-a-thons to make sure that you can assure further progression in the game to open up more chapters, which gives you access to more worlds. This is a formula that everyone is well aware of, well acquainted with, and works out totally fine in this game. It's not blowing things away or reinventing the wheel, certainly not, but it's not crashing and burning either. It's doing things completely fine, and it's got a charming aesthetic to boot. Now, if you don't like it graphically, that is fine, and there are actual objective technical issues in the game from like a mechanical standpoint. You can see, you know, the frames struggling to keep up, especially on the Switch version. But I have to admit, I kind of like the really cheesy, very literally translated mocap of all the characters. I find that super charming in kind of the cheap way. And I also really like the visual style of, especially in the first world, you can notice it the most, the way that the map actually bends and curls upward at the side. I actually really like that. A lot of people tried to point that out as like a graphical glitch, and no, that's a very conscious art style decision. And I think it looks really good. Every time I hear someone critiquing the game, I keep hearing the word momentum over and over. The gameplay needs more momentum. The controls need more momentum. If this game isn't trying to be a platformer based on momentum, then why would they? you don't get momentum just because you want it. You should get momentum because the gameplay and the level design prioritizes it. You don't have to clear large platforms by getting a running start and making sure you're at the speed or jumping at the right angle. This game is very puzzle-centric, with some platforming involved. I don't really see where the complaint here is. You saw the character, you saw the name tied to it, you looked up the pedigree, you expected Sonic or Knights, you got Kirby, pretty much. It's pretty much Kirby. You run around a colorful level, you go from beginning to end, though there are some things you go out of the way to get, just like in a Kirby game. You grab costumes, which are essentially power-ups based on these dream NPCs that you see throughout different worlds, basically being like copy abilities, because just like in Kirby, a copy ability can solve multiple puzzles, but the copy ability itself really just does one thing. Which is another complaint people had. Why do all the buttons B, A, Y, and X all do the same thing? Well, when you're playing Kirby, why does your copy ability only do one thing? Except in certain games, I understand. But it's still the same basic argument. Why does Kirby get a free pass and Balan Wonderland doesn't? It's even more convenient than Kirby in a lot of ways, because you can actually stow away two extra power-ups on top of one you have and then toggle between the two. And as you advance in a few more levels, you actually get a whole inventory of costumes, which between checkpoints, you can actually change your loadout before tackling a new area, which actually opens up way more puzzle-solving potential than something like a Kirby game would have, as well as being fully 3D instead of 2D. There's a lot more potential here for variety of designs and challenges. And look, okay, if we're really gonna jab a stake in the fucking heart of this game, let's just also say that Kirby's platforming is trivialized, because in half the games, you can fly forever, okay? So let's not act like Kirby is some golden child, because most of its platformers are trivial and shit mechanically. They're just cute, and they're fun, and they're casual, and they're just nice to sit down with and collect all the things, okay? Can we all just agree that that still just makes a game fun? Alright, if you wanna just call this ugly Kirby, that's fine. It's ugly Kirby. I actually agree with that interpretation. But let's just not blow this up into something it isn't, okay? Balan Wonderworld's not some travesty of game design. It's a janky, Kirby-like 3D platformer. It's even got a little bit of Banjo-Kazooie stuffed in there. It's got a little bit of, like, Wario Land. There's a lot of cool, very niche inspirations splashed into this game and its design, and I actually really like that about it. In this age we have right now of just these, like, either hard, grim, dark 2D indie platformers or something just basically trying to be like Breath of the Wild and Mario Odyssey at this point, it feels fresh. I do understand a lot of people probably are just pissed off that it's not like Knights and it's not like Sonic. I get it. I think even more so with the Knights thing. I really like Knights too, and that's what initially drew me to Balan Wonderworld. You're still going through dreams, you're still chasing people's dreams, you're still helping people dealing with their traumas and challenges in the real world by teaching them a lesson in their subconscious. And that was something that the original Knights into Dreams did. And through that, it instilled this heavy overarching theme of just keeping hope and keeping faith in ideas that you hold close to yourself. That is such an important part of Knights, and that whole whimsical feel that kind of comes with it, that almost fairy tale, Peter Pan-esque feel, it all stems from that same theme too, right? Knights is a lot more than just a game where you fly through hoops or, you know, just going fast and being acrobatic. It's a lot more than that. Knights is like a very specific mood. And this game still completely holds on to that theme. If there's anything that I can say that Yuji Naka kept intact, it was the spirit of Knights, and it is very much alive in Balan Wonderworld.